What is SAP? Why SAP? It means why we need to choose SAP basis. We have different modules. Lot of modules are there in SAP. But why we choose SAP basis only? Third one. What about the market for SAP basis with HANA? And what about the job security? What are the roles and responsibilities? SAP basis with HANA. Okay, so these things we are going to discuss. And the sixth one also there, that is package. Okay, so first we'll discuss about what is SAP. So first we'll discuss about SAP. So what is SAP? Okay, I will explain in general. Okay, so in general language, I will explain you for understanding, for easy understanding purpose, I explain in general language. So see here, for example, in our mobile, we have IRCTC and red bus and Ola cabs. OYO rooms, next Jet Airways, okay. So here, so for example, if you take your mobile, your smartphone, in our smartphone, these are the apps already installed. So IRCTC, so once we log into IRCTC with user ID password, with register user ID password, we are able to book like the railway tickets, and we can check the PNR status. Means IRCTC, the app will provide the service on railways. Railway service. Okay. And if you take red bus, only bus service. Bus tickets, Ola cab, cab service. The primary thing is cab service. If you take OYO, so that's a hotel booking. And if Jet Airways, flights. Okay, so see here, once we log into IRCTC, we are able to book like railway tickets, and we can check the PNR status and fare, the distance, okay, from source to the destination like this. We can, so IRCTC will provide service on only railway related only. They will not provide the bus related service and cab service and like hotel service and any flight service. The primary thing is railway service. If you take red bus, the primary thing is only bus service, like online bus tickets. Okay, so but the red bus will not provide any railway service, cab service, hotels and flights. The same way Ola cabs, the primary thing is only cab service. Okay, so if you take any of this app, Redbus or IRCTC, OVO, Ola Cabs and Jet Airways, they provide service and particular area only. They will not cover all services. Okay? Okay. So next thing, this is one side. So if you take, I think you know, make my trip. For example, if you take this app, make my trip app. We are able to book railway tickets and bus tickets and cabs. So hotel booking and flights also, flight booking also. So see here. Only one app, Make My Trip app, will provide all services. But if you take IRCTC, Redbus, Ola, OVO Rooms and Jet Airways apps, they provide service on particular area only. So the IRCTC ID is not working in Redbus. The Redbus, the user ID password is not working in Ola Cabs. Ola Cab user ID password is not working in OVO and Jet Airways. So that's an individual. But if you take Make My Trip, one user ID password is enough for railway tickets, bus tickets, cabs, hotels and flights. Got it? So in this scenario, this is nothing but SAP. It means, I think you understood, SAP look like all in one. The SAP application will provide all services in one platform. All services means, so if you take any organization, different departments are there. Administration department, finance department, sales, marketing, and HR. Like different departments. For coordination of all these departments, SAP is provided one software, that is ERP. Okay? So understood this one? So SAP is look like an all-in-one software. All departments is integrated in one application. Okay, so this is what is SAP. So actually SAP is a purely business software. Okay, please remember this one. So we'll discuss ERP. What is ERP? We'll discuss. Okay. So what is SAP? SAP stands for Systems, Applications and Products for Data Processing. So systems and applications and products for data processing. Systems, applications and products for data processing. Systems means operating systems. Applications means SAP provided applications. Product means SAP provided products. So by using systems, applications and products, we can process the data. That is the meaning of SAP. So we should call as SAP only. SAP, that is not suggested. So why? Because SAP is a company name. So we should call as SAP only. For example, if you take TCS, we are called as TCS only. Okay. So IBM, IBM only. In the same way, SAP. SAP is not a word. That's a company name. Okay. So next, basis. So SAP having number of modules. SAP having number of modules. So in that module, SAP Basis is one of the module. Basis is one of the module. Basis stands for business application software for integration system. For integration purpose, we should use Basis. That is the meaning of business application software integration system. So this is a software for integration. Integration means SAP having so lot of modules. Okay, so all modules are integrated. Integrated to SAP Basis. Okay. So see here. Next, software. So what is software? Actually, we have two types of software: system software and application software. What is system software? System software, like for example, whenever we purchase a desktop or laptop, so compulsory we need to install the OS, the required OS. Like for example, I want to install Windows 7 or Windows 8 or Windows 10, whatever it may be. The operating system what you have installed in our desktop or laptop, that is called as system software. After system software, depends on you, your requirement. Like if you want to install Java, if you want to install .NET, if you want to install SAP, those are called as application software. The first two, the OS is called as system software. Remaining any softwares like Mozilla, that is a application software. Google Chrome, that is a application software. SAP ERP, that is a software, application software. And MS Office, that is also application software. Okay, the same way SAP also one application, one of the application software. Why? Because first we install the OS. So nowadays, so almost all companies are installed SAP and Windows 2008 server only. Windows 2008 server. Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10. We are not able to install. Means we installed, but that SAP is not working on Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, and Windows XP. SAP should be installed on server editions only. Windows 2003 server, Windows 2008 server, Windows 2012 server. But Microsoft, they stopped the service for Windows 2003 server. That's why almost all companies are installed SAP on 2008 server only. Okay, so that is separate concept. Okay, so next, so ERP. So before going to ERP, I will explain one general example. Before SAP, for example, this is one of the startup organization, it's a level 3 company. Before SAP, this is the situation. The organization having 4 departments. Before SAP situation, this is, and this is level 2 company only, it's a startup company only. Before SAP, the organization having 4 departments. Administration department is there, and finance department is there, and sales department, and marketing, like HR department. Okay, 4 departments are there. 4 departments are there. But before SAP, there is no all-in-one software. The organization, not only this organization, any organization should be purchased individual softwares only. For administration purpose, they need to purchase one software. For finance purpose, they need to separate purchase separate software, and sales, they need to purchase separate software, and HR also separate software. So according to this organization, the management people, we need to purchase 4 softwares, and every software need administrator. That's why 4 administrators. Four admins. What happened here? This is level two company, startup company only. So they are not able to bear that type of amount. Means 4 softwares and 4 administrators. They are not able to recruit 4 administrators. Okay, so that is affected on the company budget. So that's why, for overcome of this problem, SAP introduced one software. Only one software and only one administrator. No need 4 softwares and no need 4 admins. So only one software, one admin. The software is called as ERP. The admin called as Basis. Okay, so this is so about the SAP once before the situation of SAP and after the situation of SAP. Okay, so okay, good. So what is ERP? ERP stands for Enterprise Resources Planning. Enterprise Resources Planning. Enterprise nothing but organization plan the resources. Plan the available resources. Organization, they can plan the available resources. For this purpose, they need a software. That is SAP ERP. Why they mentioned SAP ERP? Means a lot of ERP companies are there for identification purpose. SAP ERP means SAP developed ERP. Okay, so ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning and Planning. How to plan the available resources? Okay, so once we install ERP, this is possible. The resource planning is possible once we install ERP. Okay, so whenever SAP introduces ERP, this is very popular because of no need to install multiple softwares, no need to recruit multiple administrators. Only one software, one administrator is enough. Okay, so whenever SAP introduces ERP, this is very popular. So I think, you know, this is competition world. Okay, so whenever SAP ERP is very popular, some other companies also introduce ERP. But the thing is, out of 100%, of the market is occupied by SAP only nowadays. 72% of the market is occupied by SAP, and very less percent, that 28% of the people are looking for remaining ERP companies. Okay, so see here, you can observe here, where is 72%, where is 28% here. Okay, so what are the advantages SAP? Because of almost all, the entire market is looking for SAP, very less percent, 28% is shared by 5 companies. But the 5 companies are very big companies, but they share 28%. Why? Because what are the advantages in SAP? What are the disadvantages in remaining 5 companies? Means of 5 companies means of competitors, top most competitor of SAP. We'll discuss later. Okay,